Good morning! Yeah, that's right. Good morning. This is the Andy Bond Show, and I hope you are enjoying a wonderful day. We are live in the Greenfield Studios. I hope you're ready to rock and roll. We're going to play some music for you today. This is Home by Phil Philp. I hope you enjoy.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag.
That was Home by Phil Philp. I got a question for you. Why is there every single time where... Why is there girls that are being so beat up that they go back to their man? I don't get it. Why? They love me. No, they don't. They are one heck of a beating bully. Ladies and gentlemen, I am going to be talking about, this is a 3-hour show, so I'm going to be talking about all kinds of stuff. We're going, at 11:30, I'm going to go to Holly's show, Holly Stein, I can't even think of the name, just a minute here. Holly Stein, she has a show at 11:30 a.m., sorry. So this is going to be interesting. We're going to play the live show on my radio network. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoy. We're going to be talking about all kinds of stuff. I have some rants going on. If you want to join me, go right ahead. If you want to join me in the chat, you can. This is going to be one heck of a good show. So, stay tuned. This is me and Huey down by the schoolyard.
Ladies and gentlemen, check this out. A spectacular event in Wyoming. It might seem insane, but the Big Daddy Kane is rocking the house with Paul Simon. And my man Bismarck down in the park, even Spud Webb plays a cool part. In the video, me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
Mama pajama rolled out of bed and she ran to the police station. When the papa found out, he began to shout and started the investigation. It's against the law. It was against the law. Oh, what the mama saw, it was against the law. Ooh, the mama looked down and spit on the ground every time her name gets mentioned. Papa said, oh, if I get that boy, I'm gonna stick him in the house of detention. Well, I'm on my way. I don't know where I'm going. I'm on my way. I'm taking my time, but I don't know where. Goodbye to Rose, the queen of Corona. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. Take me away, but the press let the story leak. Now when the radical preach come and get me released, we is all on the cover of Newsweek. And I'm on my way. I don't know where I'm going. I'm on my way. I'm taking my time, but I don't know where. Goodbye to Rose, the queen of Corona. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard. See me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
Hey guys, come here, come here. Hey, huddle up around here. I've been watching you guys. You guys need some fundamentals. What I mean? Knees bent, heads up, shoulders rest. Look, you don't have to go bomb for it. Just punch the bend, come out. The hook, you don't need the bend. It's like, you just keep going in, come out, the hook. Hey, you can run that counter traffic, yeah, but just don't listen to coaches the way they used to.
Hello, my name is Andy Bond, and we are live on the edge with Holly here. We are live, ready to rock and roll with Holly Stern. On the edge, I cannot wait. Hey everybody, this is the Holly Stern, host of the On the Edge. This show is not for wussies. I discuss my opinions on the world of media, give top 10s and more. Twitter at Holly Stern. We are moments away for the coolest show ever. Stick tuned. We're going live to the Holly Stern on the edge with the Holly Stern Show. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be talking about all kinds of stuff. We're going to talk about On the Edge. I'm going to play that 30-minute show for people on the edge. So I cannot wait. We're going to be talking with some people. We have all kinds of stuff to do today. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play some more music. I'm playing some more music to get into the mood here. Once I get into a mood, holy cow, you better stand back. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's Elvis, American Trilogy. Enjoy.
Take it, baby.
Oh, I wish I was in a land of cotton. Old times there are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Sing it, fellas.
I was born early, Lord, one frosty morn. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Thank you. You're a fantastic audience. Thank you. Thank you, Dean. Purple gang, let's rock. Everybody, let's rock.
What is up? What is up? How are you doing today? We are going to be talking about cyberbullying. Yeah, that's right, cyberbullying. Bullying is bad. And we are going to have a little bit of a... Well, I'm on my radio show right now, Killer 101.4. Why don't you come on my show and enjoy? Why don't you? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play some... We're going to talk about cyberbullying. We're going to be talking about bullying. We are going to be talking about so many stuff. It's unreal. We have people going... We're just going to talk about anything. Because we need to... We need to stop bullying. We need to be nice to people. We really need to be nice to people. We do. I'm going to play you a clip from cyberbullying right now. And this clip, what I'm going to be setting up, here, let me give you a little bit of a preview. I'm going to be setting up cyberbullying, and this is the last clip saying, you got to stop being mean. Listen.
For each other, how cute.
Yeah, because that's what friends do.
Why don't you just stop attacking people on Clixers? Okay, you're making it so no one wants to go on there anymore.
Yeah, you seem to me just like any other bully, spreading hate wherever you go.
I gotta say, the way that you guys need to hurt people, it's like maybe you need to talk to someone, get some help.
See? Get some help. We really need to get some help today because we are going into a world where everything is in chaos. The president doesn't do anything. We are going into a world where we're fighting on the edge of a sword here. We are. And we don't know what to do. Our country is going into peril. We have so much crap that's going on right now. It's unreal. The only thing that is keeping us in sync is the military right now. Yeah, that's right. I said it. The military is keeping us in sync. We are so off course right now, but the military is keeping us in sync. They're going to places where we, where the stupid president wants them to go. What is with the president today? Why is it that we need to follow the orders of the president? Why can't we make our own orders? I know it's a code that you need to follow the commander-in-chief. But sometimes, I know that if you disobey an order, you will get punished. I know that, court-martial, that kind of stuff. But seriously, why is it that the president always has to be nice to Muslims? The U.S. government, and this is absolutely true, the U.S. government wants us to be mean to Muslims. Not all Muslims are bad. Yes, you can. Come on the show, killer. Not all Muslims are bad. We gotta stop. We gotta stop and face the light on stuff today. We got to. We gotta stop. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna have Killer 101.4 on my show, and we're gonna be talking about all kinds of stuff. Hey, Killer 101.4, how are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, cool. We're talking about all kinds of stuff today, like from the military to bullying to Obama to Muslims to the U.S. government. We have a whole list of stuff to do. So are you ready to be prepared?
Yeah, I am.
Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, like I said, Killer 101.4 is going to be co-hosting with me today. So, Killer, first and foremost, how is the military treating you?
So far, I'm not enlisted in the United States Army, but I'm working on going into the United States Army. I plan on going to the airborne, but that doesn't work infantry for me, I guess. And hello, I'm Taking Back America.
Hello, Taking Back America. How are you doing, my friend? Yeah, Taking Back America. You can listen to Taking Back America, the Night Talk Weekend Edition. This guy, and I'm going to play you my, they did an awesome thing for me. So I'm going to play this for you. This is my own intro for them. So I cannot believe they did my own intro. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to have some fun here. If I can figure out where it is.
Talk Weekend Edition is a production of Sam's Net Radio Network. Want to share a victory of Weekend Edition with those of the host, Peter Simpson, and Rick Ranger? Sam's Net Radio Network is not responsible for the comments made by them. 21 and over is advised. Now that we got all this legal shit out of the way, what do you say we start the fucking show?
The weekend stuff here.
I've said this before too. I wake up in the morning, I turn on the sprinkler, I'm like, who am I gonna piss off today?
11 o'clock.
Then let me ask you then, is it really as painful as it sounds to be an altar boy?
Saturday.
Okay, what? Sorry, oops, my fault. Sorry.
That's okay.
I needed the right one. Oops. Anyway. Anyway, they did the Night Talk Weekend Edition, and it was a test. And so, when was August 4th?
What?
August 11th was a Saturday, right? Oh, that was a Sunday.
But then the second music plays about blows your freaking eardrums out.
Yeah, that was how it is.
Oh, thank you. Can you please give me the right one, please? Taking Back America. Anyway, as I try and find that clip, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be talking about everything here. The military, the all kinds of stuff. So we're ready to rock and roll. Killer 101.4 is ready to rock and roll. Taking Back America is ready to rock and roll. We have the chat ready to rock and roll. We are ready to rock and roll. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's, okay, we're going to be talking about bullying, okay?
Yeah.
In the military. You're saying, Andy, how in the heck does bullying start in the military? Well, ladies and gentlemen, did the girl who was raped, burned, kicked, all kinds of stuff in the military?
But that wasn't part of the United States military. I heard about that one. That one was the one she was took in prison. She had her bone broken, burned, raped, and everything.
Are you talking about, about the Iraq, the prisoner?
Yeah, I think I remember hearing it over something.
I don't know the name.
Yeah, it was one of the ones. I can't remember. She had her, I know she was in the military, but she was taken prisoner of war. I don't know which war. It was either Iraq or Afghanistan. I can't remember.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna play that. I'm gonna try and find that clip. What happened was that when this girl was taken prisoner, she was beaten, raped, kicked, hurt, all kinds of stuff. And the funny thing is, the U.S. government tried to cover it up, saying, oh, and the girl said, oh, no, they were nice to me. But who actually knows what was the truth? The U.S. government said, oh, they were mean to them. She was mean. She was raped. She was all kinds of stuff. But the girl says, no, no, they were nice to me. Who's telling the truth? Who should we believe? The U.S. government or the stinking military? Who should we believe?
The government has been, they haven't told the truth that often anymore, so.
That's right. The U.S. government hasn't been telling the truth. I'm trying to figure out what the truth is. I'm going to try and find that clip and you decide. But you know what? In my opinion, the U.S. government should take some responsibility now for their actions, because we are sending young men and women off to war, fighting on different battles here. We have the Air Force going on different battles. We have the military going on different battles. We are sending weapons to Egypt. Why in the heck are we getting involved in Egypt? I'm sorry. It's going to backfire. You know what? If we send weapons to Egypt, I applaud that they're trying to get the brand new president away. But if we send weapons of mass destruction to Egypt, we are going
to... They may turn it against us. They may decide to turn the weapons on us after we get off. Once we give them weapons of mass destruction, they'll turn it against us.
Bingo! That's what. Hey, that's a kid not in the military yet. Killer 101.4. That's a kid not in the military yet, and he knows what's wrong and right. But you got to. It's like, when do you stop following orders? When do you stop following orders and start doing it your way? Our country is going into chaos right now. I'm going to try and find that clip while we're trying to... I'm going to try and find that clip. Military girl abused in Afghanistan. I think I can do that. I don't know.
Yeah, but if we do, I don't know, because I haven't been keeping up to date with it. I think they may, if we do transfer weapons of mass destruction over there, once we get ourselves out of there, then they may turn the weapon on us, or they may just take it apart, bring the actual bomb part of it, and take it into and bring it to the United States and blow something up like ours.
I'm trying to find the thing, and it's okay. I am asking someone from the military, and I know this is me, but can you tell me who the girl was that was raped, beaten, and kicked on with the Taliban here? If anybody's from the military, please type it in my chat box. I have no clue who it is.
I heard it before, but I can't remember what the person's name was. And I don't believe we won. I don't really know, honestly.
I have no clue who it is. From the Guardian rape in the U.S. military, American duty, dirty little secret, a female soldier in Iraq is more likely to be attacked by a... Okay, let's do this. If you don't force to say, try again.
When I was 17, I joined the army to acquire some college money and see the world. I joined during the first Gulf War, and I ended up getting stationed in Germany, where I was raped and stalked and harassed for reporting it by my comrades. They told me I was not telling the truth. It was the hardest thing I've ever dealt with in my life. I was in this club and walked in and saw this guy that had helped me earlier in the day at the finance office, another soldier, and he had written me a check for $900 that day. So I figured he was someone of authority, you know, and I wanted to thank him for having given me my check. So kind of in passing, I said, you know, hey, thanks for today. And he was like, hey, no problem. Hey, can you come outside? I want to talk to you. And I said, sure, okay. So I just stepped outside of the club, down two flights of stairs, and we were kind of outside at this point. And he says, the music's still too loud right here, and I need to tell you something about your paycheck. So I'm like, okay. So I go around the building and up a two-story fire escape with this guy. And as soon as we hit the landing where, you know, he kind of went to go sit down, I got kind of like, I stopped like behind him. I had been following him and he kind of bounced off of the staircase and he grabbed me and kicked my legs apart and threw me over this wrought iron railing like he had done this before. You know, like I was just whipped around. It happened so fast and this guy...
I'm sorry that I'm going to be continuing, but if you are a kid under 18 or under a kid, if you are not permission to listen to this, I would advise you not to listen to it because this is going to get real, real, real. So ladies and gentlemen, let's finish it.
I was so strong. And I remember just sitting there holding on to that railing, putting pressure on from my arms onto the railing, trying to keep my diaphragm lifted off of this wrought iron thing as this guy raped me from behind. I remember all the pain, you know, and I remember not wanting...
Okay, I don't get this. Why does U.S. military guys have to rape military girls? I don't get this. Why? Does anybody know why they have to be mean to military women? Does anybody know?
They think that they're going to get honor out of it. There is no honor in that. There is no honor in it.
If you're going to rape a girl, don't do it. Basically, if you do, because you will get busted. The U.S. government is just all... You know what? Today in the military, women need to fight for their jobs. They have to.
I think that women need to... I'm just saying that the women may need to... I think the men can have hand-to-hand combat, but I think the girls need to have more hand-to-hand combat so they can deal with all that.
Uh-huh. I have to agree. If you're going to be in the military, And I applaud any girl that's going to be in the military. I applaud them. Any girl in the military, I applaud them so dearly that if you're going to be in the military, more power to you. But you got to remember, I'm not sticking up for these guys that abuse women. I'm sorry, I'm not.
Well, they should send a male soldier with them when the women are going out on patrol. They need to have more men, like normal United States soldiers. Men need to go with them, so that make sure nothing happens, so they can defend them and make sure nothing, so this doesn't happen.
I was watching a Jake episode one time, and I'm gonna try and find that Jake episode. But what happened was that I know this is not, but in this Jake episode, there was a girl that was supposed to wear a in Muslim country, you need to wear a black robe on it. Have to wear a Muslim mask. Who's party time? 212. Hey, how are you doing? What is up? We are talking about the military and how the military is so bad. It's so bad right now that we need to stand up for the right. You are right, Killer 101.4. We need to have people in the middle. We need to have people who stand up for women. You are absolutely right. Have a guy soldier with a woman at all times. I have people in the military right now. I have two girls in the military. Two girls in the military. A third one that's going in. And I have some guys in the military, and they are so great. I have people in the military that I miss dearly. I do. And I pray to God that they do not get shot, they do not fall down, and these girls in the military, I have to give them props. They are one strong people. If you are going into the military, if you are a woman in the military, that takes guts. It does. That takes guts.
Yeah. I know a few people that went into the service. I know a few women that went to the service, and they got out not that long ago, but they did a lot. Some of them were infantry, some of them, you guys may think, oh, infantry's for men, but I know some people that went into the infantry and stuff like that, and I knew one that went into intelligence, and she, if you try to get anything out of her, she will not say anything to you. She uses her training in real life. Can't get anything out of her.
These guys in the girls in intelligence right now, the girls that are doing the computers, like set up everything, I have to give them props. They rock. They are on the front lines. They do not get any credit whatsoever. They don't. They set up all the computers for the real military to come in. They don't get any props. I have to give them props for that. All the cyber people that are on the internet, trolling for bad things on the internet, like cyberbullying and that kind of stuff. I have to give them props. I have to give them props because they are so good. It is so interesting how the military people are. They are strong. They are courageous. They are so great. I'm gonna play you two songs. We'll be right back. I have to take a break because if I don't take a break, I'm gonna be rambling, and I really don't want to ramble. I'm playing you two songs, The Disney Tiger Cruise and The Longest Time. I hope you enjoy. We'll be right back on The Andy Bond Show. Peace!
Man, that is big.
Daddy!
Daddy!
You know I try to be all that I can.
Vega?
Thomas!
This is my job.
Has gone on full alert.
Now when I start doubting, you help me sing.
We have to be ready for battle at a moment's notice. That's not going to be easy with 800 civilians on board.
There's got to be something that everyone can do.
Quite a tiger, that daughter of yours.
I think you should keep doing what you're doing.
You sure you're gonna be okay?
You gonna be much longer, son?
Nah, not much longer.
More than I hope for. I don't care what concert.
Holy cow, I cannot believe I found it. The name is Amanda Berry, who was raped in the military by the Iraqi people. Ladies and gentlemen, I have live. We are going live to crime. We are going live to Afghanistan right now. We are live on Afghanistan, and this is a story that has been I've been following since the day of time. Amanda Berry, rape in military, and Julie. Whoa. How are you going to be talking about Jodi Arias and Amanda Berry? This is going to be interesting, ladies and gentlemen. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's watch Amanda Berry, right? Just a minute here. Time out. I don't know. A little bit of help here.
I am currently still trying to find more stuff on here.
Okay, I think I found it. I don't know. Bear with me here.
If I told you that you could lock in a VA interest rate as low as 2.25%,
bear with me here. Okay, got it.
Homecoming. A family is reunited tonight after a local soldier returns home after a year of war overseas.
West 2's Michelle Meredith was there for the reunion and tells us why this was so special for her and her family.
At the Daytona Beach International Airport, the flags are out, the signs are up, Mama is nervous.
We're home safe, and she's home safe, and there's the plane.
The hometown hero has arrived. The hero is 25-year-old Amanda Macarilla.
Hey, she's the first person.
A graduate of Spruce Creek High School, the Army Reservist just finished a one-year deployment in Iraq, Kuwait, and Afghanistan. It seemed the tears and the cheers would never end as family, friends, and perfect strangers took it all in.
Overwhelming. I'm a little embarrassed right now with all the attention, but I'm very happy and thankful and grateful.
Amanda is a bona fide Army brat. Both mother and father served in the Army. Amanda went to college at Embry-Riddle, got her master's in aviation business, did a little modeling, became an Army reservist, and was quickly deployed.
There's a couple times that she would text and say, please pray for us, and she was over there at a time that they had the burning of the Qurans.
Amanda's tour of duty was a life changer in more ways than one. Amanda met her future husband, an Army lawyer, in Iraq. Their wedding in November will have a Middle Eastern theme, complete with treasures she bought on duty. The couple will even rent a candle for the wedding. Dee is a bridesmaid.
I'm so proud of her. She's my heart, my world.
After the wedding, Amanda will join her.
Okay, I cannot find it to save my soul here. I cannot find that stupid thing.
Let me see, because I have only found something about men and odds, and I'm still working on it. Because I watched a YouTube video of a girl that committed suicide from being being bullied, but I cannot find her.
Me either.
She committed suicide, but I cannot find her name. It's going to be the death of me if I can't find her.
You and me both. I cannot find to save my soul.
I'm gonna check on YouTube, see if I can find her name there.
The only thing I can find is Amanda Berry.
Okay, let's see.
Well, I'm gonna do this Amanda Berry. It's 30 minutes. Maybe we can find something in 30 minutes, okay?
If you make an unrestricted report, they will do an investigation. If you make a restricted report, then your name is kept secret, and so is the offender's. So he's protected. Now, of course, in the military, you are basically going against people that, if you're in active duty, I mean, these are the people that your life depends on. And report against one of them,
who?
You could be in fear of your own life.
Who did you find?
It's Amanda and Todd. Look it up in YouTube, you'll find her.
I talking about I found it. Thank you, Jesus. Bully teen commits suicide. Bully tries the American Todd nightmare. Let's see, what should we write? There isn't a video by her. I'm going to read this, okay? So...
yeah, it's just,
I know.
It's just words.
Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a Man and Todd story original. I've dedicated to tell you about my never-ending story. In 7th grade, I would go with friends on webcams. Meet and talk to new people. Then got called stunning, beautiful, perfect, etc. Then wanted me to flash. So I did. 1 year later, I got a message on Facebook. From him. Don't know how he knew me. He said, if you don't put on a show for me, I will send your boobs. He knew the address, school, relatives, friends, family, and names. Christmas break. Knocked at my door at 4 o'clock a.m. It was the police. My photo was sent to everyone.
Wow, that's fun.
I then got really sick and got... okay, I can't read this anymore. This guy is a bastard! Oh my gosh, this guy is a bastard!
I watched it and I couldn't. I only made it like halfway through the video and I couldn't watch any more of it. It makes me almost cry because of it.
This guy is a bastard, a meanie, a stupid head. Oh, if you don't do a show for me, I'm gonna send you the picture. You gotta be kidding me. You are one heck of a bully. If you ever. I wish you were in Wisconsin. Then I would literally have to kill you. I would kill you. I don't care if I have to go to jail. I would kill you. I would.
Yeah, and I have something on Wikipedia about her suicide of Amber.
Oh, you want to hear an anonymous message? Ooh, this is gonna be interesting. This is an anonymous message. Oh, I hate this. We're live. Anonymous, are you there? Can you hear me? Anonymous, can you hear me? Okay. Okay, I have to hear this. Obama responds to American Todd's story. I gotta hear this. Blah, blah, blah. Name it.
I don't know what it's like to keep it on.
Bullying is just a normal rite of passage. But it's some inevitable part of growing up.
Okay, Barack Obama, shut the hell up! It's the rite of passage? Are you serious? You are so off of a ballpark here.
Hey, you want to know something?
What?
I don't think you really want to know this, but I was reading over something on here, and the cut and how she committed suicide. She hung herself.
I know.
And which is.
I'm Barack Obama, and the word of passes is you gotta be. What are you smoking, man? It's not the rite of passage. You don't have to be bullied. Heck, she went through a living hell, Barack Obama. She did.
And she hung. She hung herself too. So you. She had. You need to know.
If you're in trouble,
getting his facts straight, and whatever he is taking, he needs to stop it.
She went through a living hell. Okay. I want you to picture this. Close your eyes, everybody. If you are a girl, if you are a boy, picture it. Okay. I want you to pretend that you are... If there's any girls on this thing, picture it, okay? Why am I getting so upset? Okay. Someone took a picture of... She flashed a guy on the webcam with boobs, okay? She flashed him. And then... This son of a bitch guy decided to send the photo to everybody. And some people even punched her. Girls at school called her a slut, a whore, a bitch. She was teased, she was punched, she was kicked. Get this for your thick saw, you piece of crap, whoever is on this internet. Oh my gosh, she was bullied, she was kicked, she was mean, she was pounded, she was so mean, she was called every name in the book, a slut, a whore, she was called so many names. I applaud her that she was courage to stand up, but seriously, if you're going to say that she had it coming, you should just get off the crack. You should. Because if anybody says that she had it coming, I will personally come on my web show. I will come on my web show and tell me that she deserved it. Amanda Todd, tell me that she deserved it and I will fight. I'm not taking any crap anymore.
Who can help? There are people out there who love you and care.
Yeah, people out there that love you and then loved you. I understand. Yeah, right. You know what? If you're going to be loved by somebody, then take it. You got to be loved, right?
Yeah.
I care about you just the way you are.
I felt like a joke in the world. I thought nobody...
When you're teased or bullied, it can seem like somehow you brought it on yourself. For being different or for not fitting in with everybody else.
Don't have any friends, and I sat at lunch
alone. You are not alone. You didn't do anything wrong. You didn't do anything to deserve being bullied.
Every day I think why I'm still here.
There's a whole world waiting for you, filled with possibilities.
You know what? I have to agree with Barack Obama. Whoa! That was weird. What happened? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't agree with Barack Obama, but you know what? You gotta stand up for people. I'm in a bully attacked by Anonymous. I'm gonna go all hell on this guy.
The David Pakman Show at davidpakman.com.
Amanda Todd is the 15-year-old who was found hanged in her home on October 10th. She was from Vancouver, Canada. Weeks after she uploaded a video to YouTube detailing how she was being treated horribly and bullied extensively by cyberbullies, now Anonymous, the internet gathering known as Anonymous, has named a man that it claims posted the topless pictures of the 15-year-old, taken, presumably, when she was only 12 years old, and harassed her so relentlessly that she killed herself. Now, I'm going to play some of that video from Anonymous for you here. I want to bear a few things in mind. Number one, during a memorial for Amanda Todd earlier this week, her friend said they were aware of a man in his 30s, quote, stalking their friend for years. That being said, we don't really know if this allegation from Anonymous is accurate. What we do know is that it is appearing to be taken very seriously. The video has an incredible number of views online. What we have to talk about is whether this is really the right way to go about indicating who this was. Here's the video from Anonymous.
Dear citizens of our nation, we have brought this announcement forwards solely for the purpose of releasing Amanda Todd's Punisher's identity.
You know what? This Anonymous should go to hell. Because he's the one that bullied people. You know what? I agree that Anonymous should... I agree on some stuff, but if you're gonna... Okay. This Anonymous should go to hell in a handbasket. Because nobody is bullied. Hey, Anonymous, if you're out there, come and fight me, you son of a bitch.
No, you will find a new URL to the man's docs in there. You will see various information about said person.
Okay, so there it is. This brings up a lot of questions for me, and the biggest one is, let's say Anonymous is right. Is this type of internet vigilante justice, where now this individual is receiving a ton of different threats of all kinds, so on and so forth, is this, on the whole, is this productive? And then the next question that I guess I would use to evaluate that would be, what is the alternative? In other words, should Anonymous simply have gone to the police and said, here's the person? Or is this really the way to go about this type of thing? He bullied on the internet, therefore now he will be bullied on the internet.
No. I am someone who generally has no faith in our legal system. I think this is how you do it.
You do think so. Natan, what do you think?
Ideally, you could say that these people should work with the authorities. However, some of their tactics are clearly illegal, in which case, even if they use illegal tactics, maybe when they finally find the guy, they should hand everything over and maybe be immune from prosecution. But at least from that point on, law enforcement won't be doing the...
Okay, I cannot hear this anymore because I'm going to kill people here. I can't believe. Ooh, Anonymous finds Amanda Todd's bully. I gotta see this.
The RCMP have been inundated with tips in their investigation into the death of Amanda Todd. She's the teenager who committed suicide after posting a video on YouTube detailing her painful experience with bullies. But as Chris Brown explains, police aren't commenting about some of the rumors spreading across social media.
24 RCMP investigators have been assigned to look into the bullying that may have prompted Amanda Todd to take her life. But the revelations that came out today had nothing to do with police. Anonymous, which often uses the Guy Fawkes image as its symbol, published the name and address of a Vancouver area man it claims was Todd's primary bully and preyed upon her online. Anonymous says a 32-year-old man, who we're not naming and who hasn't been charged with anything, lived in this house, though no one appeared to be at home. But his online activity, claims Anonymous, includes postings to child porn sites. Guilty or not, the man was eviscerated. The vigilante justice worries this defense lawyer.
The system isn't supposed to convict someone before charge is laid. It isn't supposed to be judge, jury, and execution, all in the public forum. You know, we have a justice system.
We have a justice system.
The RCMP have been inundated with tips in their investigation into the death of a man.
We have a system? What system?
I have one question for you people. One question. How can you bash somebody so much and so hard and so constantly that somebody wants to fucking die? How can you do that? How can you... You'll make fun of somebody and bully them and hurt them and torture them and make their life a living fucking hell.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
I don't care! Stop! Oh, you son of a bitch! You don't say follow a radio show on a radio show. You don't do that! I'm already mad. Now you want me to get mad at you? Why? Why do we have to be so mean to people? Well, let's check out this, let's check out Ben Radio UK. Let's check this out. Maybe I can get something. Sorry, Ben, I got mad. I'm sorry. I'm just a little mad right now. I'm on this Amanda Knott story. Amanda Todd story. I'm a little mad. Do you forgive me? Hey, Holly, how are you doing? Hey, Holly, come on my show. You can. It's the let me get you my Skype here if you want to come on my show. Andrew.Bone2, you can come on my show. Hi, Holly, how are you doing? Holly is one of my best friends. And yes, anyway, back to my rant. Why does people have to be so mean to girls? Why? I don't get it. Why can't we respect people? Why can't we respect people? Sure, I can. Oh, listen.
And so they say, all right, you're fucking torturing me. I'm going to kill myself now. I'm never going to understand that. And me, Catherine Oleg, you all know I'm a fucking big fucking asshole. I'm a bitch. I'm an asshole. I can admit it. I'm a fucking jerk. All right? I'm a fucking jerk. What the fuck ever. But I will never tell someone, you can kill yourself. Go fucking kill yourself. Go fucking die. I will never in my fucking lifetime tell that to somebody because it's been said to me. And this whole Amanda Todd situation, everyone telling, you know, everyone else just talking about, oh, it was her fault. She deserved it. She shouldn't have flashed this one. She shouldn't.
Okay, stop. People think it's Amanda Todd's fault because she flashed somebody? Are you serious? Oh my gosh! The news media is so out of whack right now. It's unreal. I gotta take some break here before I go hostile on people here. Holly Stain is gonna be coming on my Skype. We're gonna be talking about this Amanda Todd crap. Amanda Todd. People are saying that, oh, she deserved it. Seriously? Are you out of your freaking mind that she deserved it? Seriously. Are you really out of your freaking mind that she did, she deserved it? Are you serious? No, she didn't. She did not deserve it. She didn't. Nobody deserves to do it. Listen.
Fuck this one's boyfriend. She shouldn't have did this. She shouldn't have did that. What? Okay, so let's say you cheat on your boyfriend. You steal somebody else's boyfriend. You go accidentally, you know, fuck this one or fuck that one or send a nude or whatever the fuck is going on. Whatever you do, you deserve to fucking die. And not only to die, but to live such a horrible, miserable life that you make the choice to fucking die. Is in charge of your life enough.
Okay, now I'm gonna be mad. This revolution 89825, I'm laughing so hard right now. You don't understand what I said, did you? In that fact that you call this an argument, I'm sorry to tell you, you're facing a chairman of the school motto United Union Nation Club, who is particularly in numerous conferences overseas before. I'm more than certain that I can beat your argument up easily. You can make the first move. Okay, seriously? You're gonna argue about this. You're from the United Nations school motto, United Nations? Who gives a fuck? I gotta see the comments. Shut the fuck up, you passy bastard. You are trying to deny that she was a slut? Ha ha ha. You see this? Why I love arguing with people like you so much? Shut the fuck up, you passy bastard. Oh, sorry. Yeah, that was another one. Sorry. I can't read Spanish to say my so. Isn't it fun? I mean, here's the whoa, hello. Wow. Isn't it fun? I mean that you defending a person with defendant wrongdoing suicide based on emotional and nothing on personally, that's easy. Target to destroy. Their logic and argument. Shut the hell up, you rebel bastard. That's right. Why do you have to be so mean to people? Why? I love these comments. Listen to this. Pretty cool. Literally, don't waste time, guys. Rush to the site and get your iPad 3 or iPhone as per your choice. Just listen for more. For now, make sure you tell the address and email properly to send a gift box. Rush it here. Amen, girl, you spoke the truth. This made me cry so hard. Rip, Amanda. I don't. Now she felt I won't been her friend. I would save her if I knew about it sooner. You gotta save people. You got to save them. I'm gonna play some songs right now, and I hope you enjoy. This is Hello, My Name Is.
My name is regret. I'm pretty sure we have met. Every single day of your life, I'm the whisper inside that won't let you forget. Hello, my name is defeat. I know you recognize me. Just when you think you can win, I'll drag you right back down again till you've lost all belief. Oh, these are the voices. Oh, these are the lies. And I have believed them for the very last time. Oh,
Ladies and gentlemen, I am so mad right now about this Amanda Todd because people are saying she deserves it. Are you serious? She did not Hello, Holly. How are you doing today?
Hey, now. How are you?
Excellent, excellent, excellent. So, Holly, how are you listening to my little rant here?
Oh, yeah, I was listening.
Am I even in the right ballpark here, or am I just, like, off the reservation here?
Oh, I think you're right. I think you're totally right. You believe what you believe, and that's good because people are going to try to hate on you for it, but you stick up and you say it for all the world to hear about your beliefs, and you don't give a fuck what anyone says, and for that, I applaud you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be talking to Holly Stein for... Holly, would you want to stay on here and talk about this with me?
Sure, but you got to get my name right. It's Holly Stalin.
Why the heck do I call... Oh, I'm sorry. Did I really screw up your name 500 times?
Yes, you said Stein. Holly Stein or something like that.
Stalin.
Or something.
I'm just going to call you Holly, okay? Oh my gosh. And I'm surprised that she hasn't got... I'm surprised that she...
I was going to promote your show tonight, too, but since you got my name wrong,
Hey, I put in my... Okay, okay, wow. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it is so hard for me to stay straight because I have a... What in the heck is in the background?
Oh, those are carbs. I'm outside because it's a nice day today.
I know, it is. I am in Greenville, Wisconsin here right now, and it is a very nice day.
So I'm doing Skype calls from outside because nature is awesome.
Well, anyway,
Stalin.
Holly Stalin. Okay, I always wanted to do this. I'm gonna do a because I'm a goofball and I love doing a report here. So listen to the. I want you to hear this report. So let me get to your. I'm gonna on the edge, right?
Mm-hmm.
With Holly Stalin. Stalin.
Yes, my first official show starts tonight.
At what time?
I honestly have no idea. I don't have a schedule. I'm planning around the 11:30 midnight hour.
11:30 midnight hour. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here's my news report. I hope you enjoy this. Listen to this. Hello, my name is Annie Bond, and we are live outside Holly Stalin Studios right now. We are waiting confirmation what time Holly is going to perform going to go on air tonight. I cannot wait. We have news cameras ready to rock and roll. Whenever she's ready, we're going to be on it like normal. This is Annie Bond reporting live from the Holly Stalin Studios. Back to you in the studio.
That was nice.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. So, Holly, tell me about your show. Give me a little preview about your show here.
Well, about On the Edge, I used to host a show called Keeping It Real, but the show's been changed to On the Edge. It's a little bit different. Instead of... Well, I mean, it's the same controversy and stuff, but On the Edge has controversial topics, it has top tens like never before, it has comedy, it has roasting, it has my opinion on the world of media, and more.
Remind me, if you ever roast me, let me come on, okay?
Alright.
You know what, you can make fun of my show, I don't care, because you are, why I say, and you're like, people in the audience, people are listening saying, what? She can make fun of your show? Why can't I? Well, because I know that it's all fun and games.
Mm-hmm.
It's not hurtful. It's not like that. But, ladies and gentlemen, why am I talking to Holly about Amanda Todd here is because this is so messed up. Why? And maybe you can answer me this. Thank God you're a girl, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad that I have a girl on here because then I have a whole point of view here. But why? Why is it so important for people to... Why girls, teenager girls, have to be popular? Why? What does it take? Why?
Well, that's a good question. Feel like they need to be loved, especially with teenage girls. They feel like they need to be loved by not only their peers but also boys. That's a good point too.
You know what, I understand that girl.
It's all about status. It's all about the status. It's what people think of them. And if you really think about it, that's how the world is. If you look at even the world of media, like acting and singing, everybody wants to be the top dog.
I don't get it. You know what? I'm a radio show host and on speaker.com. I run my own company too, called Andy's Productions for You. I was a bully in high school. I was the victim in high school. Being a bully is very easy right now because you get more friends, more popular. But because I stand up for the weak, because I stand up for the poor, I am now the most hated person on this show.
Well, good for you.
And you know what? Do you know how many times I wanted to commit suicide when I was in high school?
How many?
All my freaking high school life I wanted to commit suicide. Because I was bullied. And you think that you're just saying that because it's true. No. I was bullied in high school. And I wanted to kill myself. My mom even knew that I wanted to hurt myself so badly. I did not want to go in. I did not want to do it because I knew that people were going to be mean to me. My freshman year was great. My sophomore, junior, and senior year was a living hell.
That sucks. Well, I was homeschooled, so I never had that experience.
I was homeschooled.
In school, but I did get bullied a lot in other things. And at one point in my life, I did want to commit suicide, and I decided not to because I realized that suicide is only a permanent solution to a temporary problem.
And people are saying that Amanda Todd deserved what she got because she flashed somebody. No, she did not deserve what she got because, you know what? It is so hard for people to figure out what to do right today. We live in a world where all the media, all the celebrities, all the people that wants to be popular, like you see on our TV right now, like, oh, if you do this, you're popular. If you do that, you're popular. You know what? How does people live with themselves? It's like a popularity contest. The whole entire world is judging you right now.
And, it is. It's true.
And you know what? I've been around the block. I know what girls call other girls. Like slut, whore, bitch.
Bitch.
All kinds of stuff. I know that. And you know what? And I hate it. I had a friend in high school that was being bullied. I had a girl who was in high school was being bullied. And the guy was calling her a slut, a whore, a bitch, a prostitute.
Oh no.
All kinds of stuff. From every cuss word, every slut, whore, prostitute, that kind of stuff. I get into prostitution later because don't let me get into prostitution because that I will go on a rant about that too. So I got to stick with one thing, okay?
Yeah.
So if I get off track, say, Andy, get the... You can even use cuss words to get me back on track. Deal?
Andy, get the fuck back on track.
Boom, right there. If I go off bunny tracks, get me... You can say any cuss word you want. Oh, by the way, who won the F off last night anyway?
Oh, it was me. Like, what happened was... It was a pretty intense battle, but like it was kind of a weird battle too, and we pretty much vowed to never do it again because it was a total epic fail. But we kept going at each other with the F-bomb, Dino kept getting points, I kept getting points, Rick was the judge, and at one point Rick declared Dino the winner, but then I said, because I was saying something that I was fucking half naked, and then I said, fuck half naked, I'm all the way fucking naked now.
What?
And then all of a sudden I became the fucking winner.
You were naked?
Not really, but I have to say that to actually get points.
Oh my gosh. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I bet Rick and Dino was like...
Don't you do radio naked?
No.
You never decide that you want to do radio naked?
No, I never, but I could just see a... you know what? You know what? I'm sorry. Oh my gosh.
But the weird thing was, they wanted to see proof of my age, and I was like, well, I'm 19, bitch. And they were like, that's not good enough. I was like, what do you want to see? My ID? And they were like, yeah. And I was like, well, that's not even safe to do on the internet.
No,
like,
if you
here's my proof. I'll show you my boobs, okay? That's proof enough. My boobs are so fucking big. I would like, that would be proof enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, why we're talking about, and you're like, and I can just see people like, what the heck are you talking about? How the heck did you get back?
I'm honest on the air. That's me. I'm honest on the air.
Me too. Anyway, we're getting off bunny trails here. Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
We need to get the fuck back on track.
Yes, okay, we're talking about bullying and a girl and prostitute.
Some girl flashing somebody.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
And what happened to her? Like, what was the consequence?
Well, are you talking about my friend that I was telling the story, or Amanda Todd?
No, I'm talking about Amanda.
Well, okay, sorry. Where's that stupid, I need some great, where? Aha! Sorry, I always wanted to do, I have to be serious now.
Get that news clip or whatever.
Nope. Okay, that's better. This is David Crowban Won't Be Quiet. Because you know what? Amanda Todd hanged herself.
Oh.
She did. And ladies and gentlemen, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, you know me. I love making fun of people, but there's certain things that I don't do.
Yes, I agree with you.
There's certain things I don't do. If someone comes on my show being a moron, yes, I'm going to make fun of them.
Well, of course.
If someone is going to promote their show without my permission, I'm going to scream at them. But if a girl ever comes...
Why don't you want promotion for your show?
I know, but some people type in my show like, "Yo, follow me." And she doesn't ask permission.
Oh, okay.
But if a girl comes on saying I'm a slut, a whore, a prostitute, then I'm not going to make fun.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only reason why I don't make fun of people right now, because it is so hard for me to go to say this right now because I hate it. Anyway, my friend girl, and let me get some music here. Sorry, can you hear that?
Yes.
Good. Ladies and gentlemen, that was a mistake. The warm music.
Why the fuck did you play that?
I have no clue.
It was just like not even, there wasn't even a purpose for it. It was just all of a sudden there's fucking music playing.
Yes, you know me. Anyway, there was a girl that was in my high school who was called a slut, a whore, a prostitute. Basically, mm-hmm. all three of them. And she was...
It happens.
Uh-huh.
I said it happens.
It does happen, yeah. I'm not kidding you. It really does happen in a high school. Why does girls have to be so mean to girls and boys? Why?
Because it's a big competition. They want to see who can be better, who can be the quote-unquote popular girl. And they'll do whatever it takes to get there.
But making fun of girls saying, oh, she slept, like, for example.
Because it's putting them down and bringing them up. That's why they do it.
You know what?
And the other thing is, the people who make fun of other people, they probably have some fucked up issues going on, too. They probably have some fucked up life where their parents are going through a divorce and they're even a bastard child. Who knows? They probably have some fucked up life and they're sitting there trying to make other people look bad so they can make themselves look good, even though they know their life is fucked up.
Ladies and gentlemen, Holly Stan.
Stalin. It's like, why is that so hard for you? Didn't you go to school? Like, didn't you learn your history? You know, Joseph Stalin?
Hey, be nice, okay? Hey, it's hard for me, okay? I don't have my glasses on, so give me a break here. I'm going to put my glasses on. I'll be right back.
Yeah, put those glasses on.
It's my radio show, so I can call you whatever name I want.
Put your glasses on, son.
Hey, it's my radio show, so I can call you any name I want.
I can roast you, too. I mean, it's called freedom of speech. I can go on your show and roast you all I want.
Go right ahead, bring it on.
Just did.
Ooh.
Your turn.
Oh, what now? Right. You got those glasses yet?
Yes! I do have my glasses on!
Okay, good. We don't have to, like, hum Jeopardy music so that we can make sure that there's no dead air.
Oh, just be quiet! Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, I had so many guests on. When I have guests on, all the crap that I'm talking about goes out the door. All the crap that goes off the
door. Well, you want to see more of this and watch On the Edge tonight? I'm going to be talking about top tens. I'm going to be talking about what not to say to your girlfriend. And I'm going to be doing another show afterwards, roasting all of the shows combined in one.
Oh, great.
This should be pretty interesting.
This is going to be, I hope. Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned because next up, Holly Stan. Stalin. Gotcha.
Thank you.
Gotcha. I'm just making fun of your name now. Payback. Holly Stalin. Holly Stalin. Holly Stalin is going to be on at 11:30 or 12 o'clock. I have no clue because, you know what? It's speaker.com. She can do a show anytime she fucking wants.
Indeed. A fucking man.
Anyway, let's get back to... Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we got to get back on track here. We're going to have some fun here. We're having fun. I'm trying to get back on track here, but you know what? If you know my radio show, if anybody ever listened to my radio show, once someone comes on the air, we go in bunny trails, ladies and gentlemen.
Are you ADD?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. I do have ADD. And I'm in another...
It seems like ADD is, like, populating. Even people that don't actually have a doctor's written note, they say, I have ADD, so that's why I can't concentrate.
Actually, I don't have ADD. I just want to...
Everybody says they have ADD. It's like, what the fuck? It's like you want to have a problem. It's like, come on, people.
I just have a lock of sugar here.
Yeah. Need to get some of that coffee.
I don't drink coffee. I drink Diet Mountain Dew. If I get a Diet Mountain Dew, I'm good.
Diet? You drink Diet Mountain Dew?
Yes, I do.
Oh, that shit's nasty.
No, it isn't. Mountain Dew is nasty. Mountain Dew is nasty.
I just threw up out in the air, ladies and gentlemen.
I just realized something. I can cut you off anytime I want, but I'm not going to do that.
You can fucking make fun of me in every single way, and I won't give a fuck because I don't get offended.
I know. This is what
I... You're sitting there saying, "Stop it, stop it," and I'm like, "Come on, come at me, bro."
I don't do smack talk to each other. If you, I don't do smack talk because I'm never good. If I had Rick, if I have Dino on the show. Then we're gonna have some fun here.
Get Dino on then. Like, put Dino on the line as well, and we'll see what happens.
Oh, crap.
Do it.
I don't know if Dino is on the... I don't think Dino is on.
Just give him a call and see what happens. Just make sure you don't kick me off the air.
Hello, I don't have Dino on my Skype line here.
Oh, then just put the Fuck You Network, and then Dino will pop up.
I know, I have Dino, but...
Then call the show. Call him.
I can call the show?
No, yeah, you can call him, and he's going to... If he's there, he will pick up, and he will be connected to all three of us, and we will
What
have...
is with the green... What's the with the green circle on with the white thing on?
It means they're online, I think. Just do it.
Holly, can you hear me?
Yes.
Good.
What are you doing?
Calling Dino right now.
Alright, then do it.
I did already.
Did you pick up? Is he picking up?
Relax!
I'm just saying.
Jeez! Girls.
I'm just making sure you're not making up excuses not to call in.
Called, fail. Dino, are you there? Call, fail, crap.
Well, if the call failed, chances are he's probably not there.
I don't know how you hang up. I don't want to hang up on you. I don't know how you hang up on people here.
Well, it also says that Dino's in my conversation, so who knows what the fuck's happening. So just don't hang up, because if you hang up, then I'll be off the air.
And then you can call me back again.
No, you better not hang up on my ass, or I'll hang up on your ass.
I won't hang up on you, I promise. Anyway, we are 79 minutes out of a 3-hour show here, ladies and gentlemen. Bum, 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 bum.
Okay, seriously, this is a radio show. We probably shouldn't be going the whole time.
Bum, 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 bum. It's my radio show. I can do whatever I want. And people think I'm popular on my radio show because I get to the guts of it.
I still haven't heard your attempt at roasting me yet.
Okay. Holly Stalin
and
is...
I'm your judge, too. I'm going to tell you if you suck or not.
Okay, Holly Stalin is so fat that when she was a baby, she had to slap the doctor. Wow, that was lame.
That was lame. First of all, here's my judging. I'll judge you on that. Okay, first of all, it was a good attempt. You tried to sound like you had passion in that and tried to believe it. But unfortunately, you felt a little bit short on the passion. And another thing is you gotta drop the ums, and you gotta make sure you're not stuttering when you roast someone. You have to be clear, concise, and direct. That is Judge Holly Stalin's word to you.
Can you do any better?
What was that voice? Can you do any better?
Can you do any better, girlfriend?
She sounded like an old lady from New York.
No, this is an old lady. Jesus, Holly, can you do better?
No, that sounded like Elmer Fudd from Bugs Bunny.
Shh, I'm hunting rabbits.
No, it's not rabbits, it's wabbits.
No, it's rabbits.
No, he says rabbits. He does not say
rabbits.
You need to watch some more cartoons, son.
And you gotta be nice to me on my radio. Wait a minute, hold a timeout.
I'm not nice to anybody.
I just realized that. Never mind. Anyway.
I'm on your show, and I'm on here acting like a moron. I have one question for you.
Okay, now we're going to get some interesting here. This is Re-American Todd suicide video. This is, this was posted to a person, and ladies and gentlemen, this is interesting because you have someone that's saying that I'm a bitch, I'm a slut, I'm a whore, I'm a prostitute, basically that. But what does the video even listen? And we're just going to discuss that. Listen to it.
All right. One question. How can you bash somebody so much and so hard and so confidently that somebody wants to fucking die? How can you do that? How can you make fun of somebody and bully them and hurt them and torture them and make their life a living fucking hell until they say, all right, you're fucking torturing me, I'm gonna kill myself now? I'm never going to understand that. And me, Catherine Olek, you all know, I'm a fucking big fucking asshole. I'm a bitch, I'm an asshole, I can admit it. I'm a fucking jerk. Alright? I'm a fucking jerk. What the fuck ever. But I will never tell someone, you can kill yourself. Go fucking kill yourself. Go fucking die. I will never in my fucking lifetime tell that to somebody because it's been said to me. And this whole Amanda Todd situation, everyone telling, you know, everyone else just talking about, oh, it was her fault, she deserved it, she shouldn't have flashed this one, she shouldn't have fucked this one's boyfriend, she shouldn't have did this, she shouldn't have did that. Okay, so let's say you cheat on your boyfriend, you steal somebody else's boyfriend, you go accidentally, you know, fuck this one, or fuck that one, or send a nude, or whatever the fuck is going on, whatever you do, You deserve to fucking die, and not only to die, but to live such a horrible, miserable life that you make the choice to fucking die. Who the fuck is in charge of your life enough to determine whether you should live or die? Who the fuck is in charge of that?
I'm sorry, I can't read, I can't listen to this anymore because A, I'm going to be mad, and B, I'm going to scream up at people. I'm going to blow up on people. I can't listen to this anymore.
Yeah.
All I have to say is these guys are bullies. B-U-L-L-Y-I-N-G. You know what?
So, if I understand this right, okay, this is really weird. Why am I hearing myself on the air?
Because you're live on the air.
Yeah, but I didn't hear myself on the air previously, and when I'm talking, it's like...
Because I turned up my volume.
Turn down your volume.
I turned up my volume.
Turn it down.
Why?
Because it's bothering me. Because I can hear myself as I'm speaking. Okay, that's much better.
Sorry.
Okay, thank you. So, if I understand this right, Amanda killed herself because people were making fun of her because she flashed.
Well, what happened was that some friends were on a webcam and she flashed a person on the thing with her boobs. And what happened was that the guy Facebook her and said, "Oh, you're gonna do a show for me, or else this picture is gonna go out to everybody." So I think she did a show for her. Show for him like. Stripping down, that kind of stuff. I don't know. I don't have all the facts.
What are these people? Okay, if they're making fun of her because of that, what are they, fucking three? I mean, come on. Everybody... Okay, you look at yourself when you take a shower. You look at yourself when you're naked in bed having sex. So...
Can I tell you something? I do have a little confession. I never had sex with a girl before.
You never had sex before?
No.
Well, thanks for sharing that on the air.
Hey, don't worry about it. I'm an honest book here.
Yeah, you gotta be honest on the air.
Anyway, yes, I never smoke, I never drink, and never looked at another girl before. Anyway, why the heck did I just say that? Oh my gosh.
Everybody now knows your sex life.
Yes. How about yours? Why don't you tell me you, why don't you, what's your sex life, Holly?
I know. Well, let's see. Honest on the air, are we?
Yes, let's go. Bruna, hey. This is my show, so... Ha!
Ha.
Anyway, why I was honest with that is...
I've only had one boyfriend.
You had one boyfriend? Cool.
And I don't know if I'm ever going to get another one.
Why?
Because he's a fucking douchebag.
Oh, wait a minute. I have a perfect song for your boyfriend. I have a perfect song for her. Him.
Him. Okay, I'm not a lesbian.
What the heck? What the heck? This is going out to all the boyfriends that are douchebags.
This is for you, Danny.
I have a whoa. Oh crap. Sorry, I have to deal with DJ Dinesh. What the heck are you doing here? Oh my gosh, you know who's on my Skype line, right?
Wait, who's on the chat?
DJ Dinesh, Dino. Who is a freaking bastard?
Put him on.
Hey, DJ, I got a question for you. Put me on, go on my, Skype me and be on my show. If you don't want to chat with, chat. If you don't want me to chat, then I can leave. Laugh out loud. Hey, DJ, put on the... Come on. I dare you to come on my show. I dare
you. You fucking chicken.
Hey, I dare you to come on my show and make fun of me. I dare you to. Come on.
Do it, you chicken. Bum 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 bum. He is such a chicken.
Yes, he is. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gonna... Oh, well, you know what? If anybody is ever going to come on the show with me, you better know that I'm going to fight. I'm going to have some fun.
Or is he being too much of a chicken?
Wait a minute, I have a... I don't make fun of people. Come on, go on, come on my show, you moron.
Yeah, you moron.
I'm calling you out once and for all. Come on my show, come on. Bring it on, you. You don't make fun of people? Does this ring a bell? You made fun of Came Back America, Dino, Madonna.
Whoa, wait, hold on now. He made fun of Taking Back America, Rick, and he made fun of Dino?
And Madonna. And
that guy's got some balls.
I know. If she's gonna, if he's making fun of him, holy cow, he has guts. Come on my show and bring it on, you son of a bitch.
Yeah, and if you want to, go ahead and make fun of me, because I'm ready for this.
Oh, me too. Come on my show, I dare you to.
If you make fun of me, I will make fun of you and make you look like a piece of trash, you fucking moron.
Ladies and gentlemen, we... Anyway, we're going to play Blinded by the Light. Maybe this guy is going to wake up one day. Oh, we haven't made jokes about you. You want me to? I will.
Why isn't he calling? Why is he in chats?
You guys make jokes about me. Why you guys talk like that to me?
Why is he only confining his insults to the chats? Why doesn't he come on the air and say it on the air?
Come on. I want you to come on the air, DJ Dino, and make me, put your side of the story on here. Because, you know what? You are close for me. Come on. I'm not making fun of you. I'm not making jokes about you. If you want me to, I will. I will make jokes about you. Trust me.
Get on the air.
Well, okay. If you want me to make jokes about you, okay. Wow. Dino.
If he's not going to get on the air, he shouldn't be sitting around talking shit.
Listen to this. How are you doing? If you don't want me to chat, then I can leave. Laugh out loud.
Really?
I don't make fun of people. You guys make jokes about me. Why you guys talk like that to me? What is with the spelling here?
Who talks like that?
It's like I'm from the hood, man.
I'm way more macho to call on air
because you guys are humiliating and talking shit about me.
I'm from the motherfucking hood.
Come on, go on the show. Come on, man. Come on, please. I'm begging you.
Pants on the ground. You're looking like a fool with your pants on the ground.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you are tuning in right now, we're trying to make this DJ. We are having fun with this guy.
I'm from the hood. What I do is I wear shades, and then I put a ball cap on, and then I put a hood over that. So when I walk around, I slouch down, I look around everywhere, making sure the popo ain't out there.
I'm leaving, and I'm way professional. I don't do this for hobby. Wow, you're a professional. Oh my gosh.
Did he just say, I don't do this for hobby, not for a hobby?
I'm a professional, man. Oh man. Hey, Holly. I had to say sorry that I'm messing with a professional here. He's a professional. Oh my gosh. I'm a little teapot.
I'm a little butt.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to know more about this DJ Dinesh, or AKA Mr. DDD,
he's so professional, I never even heard of him.
Oh yeah, he is. Yeah. I don't do this for a hobby. Seriously?
He probably has the free account. Like, he probably doesn't even have to pay for his shows. That's how professional.
Oh no! Guess what? Who's on Music Road Radio? He's the manager of this.
Ooh, he's so professional. It's Spreaker, okay? Spreaker. Yeah, people can be professional on Spreaker, but that doesn't mean they're like on. It's not top notch, okay? It's Spreaker. It's not like they're Howard Stern.
Who the heck is Howard Stern?
He's making himself to be like he's Howard Stern. You don't know who Howard Stern is, and you're in the radio business?
No, I don't know who Howard Stern is.
Oh, fuck. You need to look that shit up, man.
Well, Dino, the FU network tell me that I'm the Jay Leno
If you don't know who Jay Leno is.
I know who Jay Leno is. He's
Jay Leno?
Hey.
You call him Jay Leno. Jay Leno. I know who Jay Leno is.
Jay Leno. Help me, please. What is his name?
Jay Leno.
Jay Leno.
Not Jay Leno.
Ladies and gentlemen, why people love my show is because this is the...
Because I'm on it. That's why.
Fact.
Holly Stern.
I'm just going to call you Holly S and be done with it, okay?
Just call me Holly.
Okay. I had many great guests on my speaker show. I had Rick. I have Dino. I had DJ Mark. I had Night Talk. Jay Sands. I had Ernie. I'm Regia. I've been on great interviews
with... Did you have Bert, too? Did you have Bert and Ernie come on at the same time?
I could not get Bert and Ernie on the air. Sesame Street was tying me up with all this legal crap. So I just got done with Bert and Ernie. Yeah, they were...
You just got only the half package. You just got Ernie.
Yeah, not Bert. I'm sorry, but... I got Ernie Albert, so yes, Sesame Street was being a bitch about it. That I could not get the Sesame Street game, so all this legal crap. All this legal crap. Holly, are you still there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what?
There was a little awkward silence there for a minute, and I've told this to people, but I just want to get this out to everybody, just so you know. That whenever there's an awkward silence, a gay baby is born.
We are, oh my gosh. Please tell me we're not talking about gay people now.
Oh, I bash gay people. I'm not going to do this. I'm cutting on this. Ugh. Now I'm all tongue-tied because you got me all tongue-tied.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Payback!
On the Edge is not going to make fun of gay people. But if you ever listen to my old show, Keeping It Real, I bash them all the time.
You know what? We are, I don't know why everything is... You know what? This newest sexual bathroom is now on the... In Oklahoma. Did you hear about this? They're making bathrooms for special people that don't know if they're a girl or a boy.
Are you serious?
I'm not kidding you. Oh my gosh, a girl or a boy. And Night Talk was on this thing, and I'm like, seriously, go Jay, because Jay ranted on this.
Jay's kind of creepy, okay? I asked Jay if he would give me some candy, and he said yes.
He is creepy.
Mm-hmm.
He is.
Great, there's a motherfucking helicopter flying over my house. Really? Stupid helicopter, I'm on the fucking air.
This is Anyone Live from the air of Holly Stalin's house overhead with the helicopter. This is we are waiting confirmation when it starts. Okay, back to you in the studio, Bob.
Who's Bob?
I'm making it up, okay? You never heard of What About Bob? It's a movie.
No.
Wow.
You've never heard of Howard Stern. I think that deserves a wow. Don't you watch America's Got Talent, even?
Oh, that's the guy. Okay, I know who Howard Stern is now.
Duh.
You just had to tell me about America's Got Talent. I know him.
And you need to listen to his radio show because he's a genius.
Correct.
Baby was born again.
And him, very funny. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to have some fun here. We are still in 60-minute mode. Oh, great. We're in 60-minute mode now. We can do a 60-minute show. This is on 60 Minutes. My name is Annie Bond. We are live from the prison right now, and we are waiting confirmation if Julie Arias is going to be shot or killed today.
She's going to be shot and killed.
You know who Julie Arias is?
No, but I'm pretending I know.
Well, Julie Arias is a was on HLN and had this big trial and
wait. Julia is a guy?
Judy Arias.
Oh, Judy.
Jody Arias? Jody? What is it? Jody?
Jody. It sure as heck ain't Judy or Julie, I can promise you that.
Oh, we're gonna do Amanda Bynes.
Get that research up.
Give me a break here, okay?
Hey, I'm just trying to fill dead air.
Shut up!
I can't shut up, I do radio. I have the gift of gab.
Wow. Amanda Bynes is on the Dr. Phil show. Oh my gosh.
How is she on the Dr. Phil show? I thought she was dead.
Amanda Bynes is alive and well.
Oh, okay. There's so many people. There's so many Amandas.
The View!
They could use some professional help, so we're putting one of the most popular docs in the business to work right now. Please welcome back the author of the number one New York Times bestseller, Life Coach, Dr. Phil McGraw.
Okay, who names a kid McGraw?
I have no idea.
Oh my gosh, it sounds like a freaking Labradoodle. Here McGraw.
That was really bad.
Oh my gosh. Why? Why did I have you on? Why? I'm regretting every minute of this.
Really?
I'm joking. No, I'm not.
Well, you could. I wouldn't care.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be talking... Okay, we're talking about bullying, okay? Were you bullied? Were you bullied?
Yes.
Tell me about it.
Well, the thing is, I mean, a bully can be nice, but they're only nice to people that they're friends with. And as far... I consider myself a bully just because I'm so mean to people. I bash people. Like, I make fun of people wherever I go. I could make fun of my friends. But the people that I hang out with are the people that, if I make fun of them, they can either A, play along, or B, throw one back at me, or C, just laugh about it and say, oh, it's true.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, bullying is bad, but I'm doing a campaign.
I know it, because I'm an asshole, so I know it's bad.
I'm going to do a campaign. Starting September, when kids are back at school, I'm starting a campaign. I want every DJ, if DJs are willing to come on my show and talk about bullying and all kinds of stuff. Mm-hmm. That's my campaign. I'm gonna put the hell out of this bullying stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna listen.
What happens if Dino comes on your show and promotes bullying?
Oh, trust me.
It's a religion. It's a religion now, bullyism.
Bullyism is a religion now? Seriously?
No, I'm just kidding with you.
You better.
Well, maybe I'll make it a religion. I'll have my own religion. All my bullyism followers follow me because I'm their god. I'm already their judge, so I might as well be their god.
Okay, I'm not even going to go there. There is something screwed up with you right now, but I'm not going to go there. There's something messed up with you in your head.
It's so true.
Psycho!
Uh-huh.
Stalker!
Holly, I'm not a stalker.
So, Holly, where are you located anyway?
See, who's the stalker now? You call me a stalker, now you want
to... Hey, I know. Where are you located, okay?
I'm in Ohio, you stalker.
Ohio? I've been to Ohio. Very great place.
See, now you're going to stalk me. You're going
to... No, seriously, I came to Ohio with my mom and dad. I went down to the... I saw the state capitol, baby. That's interesting. That's interesting, that big state capitol. People were making fun of me because I'm from Wisconsin.
Why would they make fun of you for being from Wisconsin?
Oh, because of this big political battle we had with the bargaining right. Ohio!
Oh my gosh.
I love Ohio.
Who doesn't?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play some more music and we'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be roasting Chris Top, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey now, everybody.
Well, that was proper timing.
I know, right?
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be roasting Chris Top. If you don't know who Chris Top is, well, where have you been? Under a bus?
Under a rock. The term is under a rock. What is this under a bus stuff?
Wait, I want to say under the bus. Why can't I say it? Under the bus?
No, when you throw someone under a bus, that's a whole different thing than living under a rock.
Are you just going to be condescending to me every single time?
Yes.
Yeah, piece of crap.
So are we going to talk about Chris Top?
Yes, I need to get to I need to get to his program. Give me a break here. I'm not that fast like you are. Okay, jeez. Chris, what?
I had like a frog in my throat or something.
So, how did you break up?
We are on.
Your last boyfriend or
girl? Okay, enough.
Maybe you changed your Facebook status. I don't know. But if that's what you did, that was a pretty good idea.
Winnie the Pooh is based on psychological problems. Pooh has an eating disorder. Piglet suffers from anxiety. Tigger has ADD. Rabbit suffers from OCD. Eeyore battles major depression. Christopher Robin must be a drug addict if his stuffed animals talk to him.
No beloved childhood characters were harmed in the making of this ringtone. Well, at least not intentionally. Pooh did try to eat Piglet, and of course this worried Piglet until he died. Tigger couldn't stop shaking Rabbit's hand, and of course that drove Rabbit insane. And Eeyore hung himself because he couldn't deal with the fact that Christopher Robin was a drug addict.
Okay.
I agree with Chris Top 100% on that, because Pooh Bear is so messed up.
Oh my gosh, guess who's in the chat? Chris Top!
Chris Top, wow. Hey there, Chris Top. We were just not roasting your show at all.
No, Chris is on Skype.
Oh, he is. Get him on. This should be interesting.
Okay, why is this not coming on here?
Dead air.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, while we're trying to get Kissed Up on the line, we're going to play some... We're going to be roasting people here. Chris, fact, did you know that Chris Topp is a moron?
I don't think Chris Topp's a moron.
Yes, he is.
Chris Topp's great. He's a genius.
No, he isn't. Chris Topp is not a genius.
Yes, he is. Chris Topp is brilliant.
Oh, whatever. Where have you been? Under a rock?
I listen to his show. I listen to his shows, like, every time they're on. If I can't make it live, I listen anyway. Because he has probably one of the best shows on Spreaker.
Oh, but lonely. I have the best show on Spreaker, baby.
Well, that's good, because he said that everybody needs to say they have the best show on Spreaker. Now, I didn't say Chris Topp had the best show on Spreaker. I said he had one of them, because let's be honest, you know, my show is the best.
No, you might. No, I'm sorry. My show is the best, hands down.
No, my show is the best.
No, my show.
No, my show.
My show.
Alright, so we got Christopher Topp on the line.
No, we don't.
Chris Topp.
No, we don't have Chris
Topp. Top-notch programming.
We don't have Chris Topp on the line here. I'm trying to figure out how you get people on the line here.
Just call him.
I'm trying here. But it's not working.
It's not rocket science.
You try and call him.
I can't. I'm on my device. You're on your computer.
I can't. I need to add a phone number.
Well, you don't need a phone number. You just need to put in the search. Put Chris Topp.
I have Chris Topp, and I can't get him on.
Or just click on the voice chat and start talking. Just do what you did with Dino.
Hello, it's not working. Give me a break here.
Well, what did you do with Dino? You tried to get Dino on phone.
I know, but how does...
That's the same thing. You just do what you did with Dino.
Well, I'm gonna let you see me for about 5 seconds. Hey, how are you doing?
I do not see you.
You don't?
No.
Okay.
All you need to do.
It's not working. Give me a break here.
I'm just trying to help.
Stop helping. Oh, yeah. Well, fact, did you know that Chris is Chris Bond?
Chris Bond? Hmm.
Yeah. He's another Bond family. He's another Bond member. Oh, my name is Andy Bond. So, did you know that Sarah is Sarah Bond too?
I did not know that.
But I call him Chris. I call them Chris Top and Kiss Kiss.
Did you just say Chris Cock?
I said Top. I said Top.
You said Cock.
No, I said Top.
Chris Cock.
I said Top. I said Top, not Cock. I said Top.
Sure you did.
Yeah. Why do I have you on the line?
Because I'm fucking awesome. That's why.
Yeah, you are. I have to admit it. I don't want to.
Working on it.
I really don't want to. But ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play some Footloose.
Yeah.
Get ready, get your dancing shoes on. We're ready to rock and roll. This is the official video.
Hey, the movie's just about to start.
How's the crowd in there?
It's a little slow so far.
Well, we'll see if we can't do something about that.
I bet you can.
All right.
Enjoy the show.
Thank you, brother.
Okay, I bet you're ready to dance some Footloose, baby!
My car, 8 hours for what? Oh, tell me what.
for my knees. Jack, get back. Come on before we crack. Lose your boots. Everybody cut for loose. You're playing so cool.
Okay, sorry, I just have to stop that right now because
I just wanted to tell everybody that I was twerking to that song.
You are what?
I was twerking to that
what
song.
What the heck is twerking?
How do you not know what twerking is? Where have you been? Under a rock?
No, I'm from the Amish community, but I am now a American.
Amish. You gotta watch out for them Amish.
Wow. Are you gonna make fun of me tonight on your show too?
Yes.
Great. I have to come on your show and defend myself.
Uh-huh.
Or I do it tomorrow on my show, one of the two.
There you go. So, how's it going with them Skype? Is there a way that you could stop talking to Dino without hanging me up?
I have no clue. I really don't want to hang you up.
And another gay baby was born.
I don't know. There's not
a lot of gay babies right now.
What?
There's been a lot of gay babies born in this show.
I don't want to hang you up, Holly. I really don't.
Then don't do it.
I won't. Ladies and gentlemen, I am really hungry right now, and so I'm going to take a shower. I'm going to cut this thing off right now.
You're going to bring me in the shower with you. Woo-hoo.
No, I'm sorry. Man, I wish I had a girl like you. Okay, I got a question for everybody on my speaker show. I'm sorry. This is going to be a lame-ass question, but... Do you think Holly Stalin and me should date? Yes or no?
Hey, no.
The Holly, I can just, if I put that on tonight's show on Jay show, do you know how many people would give me a crud and you too?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Put it on Jay's show tonight and see what he says.
I know. I'm going to do it.
Are you going to call into his show or are you just going to put it in the chat?
I'm going to put it in the chat.
Do it. I dare you.
I will. Ladies and gentlemen, do you think Holly Stalin? I said that right, right? Do you think Holly and me will make a great couple, yes or no? What do you think, Holly?
Who's all in the chat right now?
Well, I don't know. I hope people are in the... Holy...
Go in your chat and see who's talking.
Nobody.
Wasn't Kristoff just here?
Nope.
Yeah,
but
he was.
No, he wasn't. He was not in my chat box.
Yeah, you did. You said Kristoff is in the chat.
No, I said Kristoff is on Skype.
Oh, okay.
But do you think we will make a cute couple? Yes or no? That's interesting.
That is very interesting.
I want to put that in the tonight's Jay Sands chat and see what people say, yes or no. Holly and me.
They'll probably tell you to fuck off or something.
Interesting, but you know what?
Uh-huh.
I really want a girl, right, Bailey? I really want a girlfriend badly.
I know you do.
Okay, question. I have to ask you a question.
Okay.
If I was walking in Ohio and you saw me, would you date me, yes or no?
No, because you would be a stranger and I don't date strangers. If I didn't know you and you were just a random dude walking in, I wouldn't throw myself at you and say, "Let's date, honey, hubba, hubba, hubba."
Okay, but if you knew me, would you date me? Yes?
I don't know, because I'm not dating right now. I don't know. I'm not dating, so I don't really have plans on dating right now.
So you want to be a single per... You want to be a... You could always do a... You could always try the gay route, being a lesbian.
Heck no. I'm okay.
I'm sorry. Hey, now I'm getting... Where was this 5 minutes ago?
There you go. You're starting to be able to roast me a little bit.
Where is this 5 minutes ago when I needed it?
Exactly.
Would Holly be a good lesbian, huh?
Would Holly be a good lesbian? If I were a lesbian, I would say I'd be a pretty darn good lesbian.
I can just picture it right now in my head.
I would be a good lesbian. I would be able to please women. Because I am a woman, and I know what women like.
I know, it would be much easier. Okay, this is now a stupid question. Now we're getting into real topics here. What was this 5 minutes ago, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so why does girls love kissing girls and having sex with girls? Why?
Well, I don't know how to answer that question. They just do. I mean, they like it because it's fun. It's a girl and a girl, and you can do this without being lesbian. I mean, there's girls that are bi, that like both girls and boys, which uh-huh. I'm okay with people being bi, but full-out lesbian is kind of nasty. Full-out gay is kind of nasty, but I'm okay with people being bi. Okay if a woman is bi. I don't really like a man being bi. It's my preferences, and I think it's weird.
I understand why guys want to be guys and girls want. I wouldn't be mine if lesbians and I wouldn't be mine if you have lesbians and lesbians, girls on girls. I'm sorry. How many guys would get to? How guys would be in heaven right about now? Hello. Of course, that would be on pay per view, baby. You will make a killing! Girl, I have to know, are you serious?
That's called porn.
Yeah.
Welcome to the world of porn.
I don't watch porn, to tell you the truth.
What boy doesn't watch porn?
I don't!
Well, good for you. You probably shouldn't be watching porn at your age.
I'm 24, I'm gonna be 25 on Friday.
I thought you were like 18.
You really think I was 18? No, I'm going to be 25 on Friday. But you know what? That would just be interesting. Girl-on-girl action, and you know what? Why hasn't this come out on TV yet? I think people will pay money to see that.
It's on TV.
It is?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, WWE Wrestling. Never mind. I'm sorry. Diva versus... I'm sorry. You know what? If you're gonna have a girl fight, have an actual girl fight.
I agree. The wrestling matches on there are like.
If you're gonna have a girl fight, have a girl fight. Get down and right dirty. I'm sorry.
What happened to the mud wrestling? They used to have mud wrestling. They don't have that anymore.
I know mud wrestling. Hello.
Exactly.
Girls in mud. Boys. I swear to God, boys. Boys were downloading that on the computer. The computer crashed.
The weird thing is, though, my mom hates mud wrestling. Every time she saw me watching it, she would say, "You don't need to be watching that kind of stuff. It's degrading to women, and you shouldn't be watching it."
Seriously, our world is so out of whack.
I know, everybody acts like they're a virgin and they're three.
Oh, you don't watch that because it's degrading to women. Why do these women do this? It's degrading, seriously. Oh my gosh, you know what? If a girl wants to find out what a girl does, be my guest. If you wanna have sex with a girl, be my guest.
Exactly, stop living under a rock, stop being a hermit, stop pretending like
you know what? I'm a Christian. My mom and my dad always says, gay is bad. Being gay is bad. Because in the Bible it says one man and one woman, not two men or not two women. And you know what? I have lesbian friends to tell the truth.
Mhm.
I do. I seriously do.
Yeah, I have lesbian friends. Well, I have a lot of friends that have lesbian friends.
And the finding is I can talk with the lesbian friends, and I can get inside information about that. That's the funny thing is. Mm-hmm. That is the funniest thing is that you can get inside information about being a lesbian, even if you don't want to know it. Mm-hmm. That's the funny thing is that it's like, what the heck? Our universe is so whack up, it's unreal.
Indeed.
What is with our government? What is with our media here?
There's a lot of shit going on there.
Oh my gosh, don't even get me started on Barack Obama.
Oh, Barack Obama. It's called a White House for a reason, you know.
Not a Black House.
Okay, that joke was really bad. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everybody. I made that joke before.
Just a minute, let me get some drums.
I take that back. That is actually a really bad joke. I've heard people tell the White House joke where they're like, talk about Obama, and they say, well, Obama's black, he's living in a White House, it's not a black house, it's a White House, and I've told that joke before. And I've gotten people that were so mad, they were like, sending me hates, and I told it on my show before, and I had to actually apologize for saying it. So I cannot tell that joke. That joke is like, fucking messed up.
And what is with these whorehouses now? Seriously.
Whoa, I know.
Wow, okay, where did that come from?
What is with these whorehouses?
Oh my god. I am really on... A, I'm really on crack, or B, I'm really, really having someone in my head with a gun saying, say this.
Wow. We go from talking about politics to... What the fuck is up with these fucking whorehouses these fucking days?
And don't forget lesbian too. So we went from gay to politics to whorehouses.
Where is your mind at right now?
My mind is so bad, it's unreal. It's so messed up, it's unreal.
That's great.
My mind is so screwed up right now, it's unreal. Scientists even pay me money to look at my brain. Well, ladies and gentlemen, wow. Well, it is 144 to be exact, in Greenville, Wisconsin. I think it's 144 in Ohio, correct?
No, it's 244.
It's 244 in Ohio! I've been to Ohio. Okay, seriously, if you ever want to go to Ohio, that is a great place to go, baby. Downtown Des Moines, Iowa? Oh, not mine. I'm talking about Iowa, not Ohio. I always get those two mixed up. So if you're from Ohio, are you a Iowa Buckeye fan?
Oh, yeah, I'm a Buckeye fan.
Ooh, I'm a Wisconsin Badger fan, baby.
Well, Andy, it was great being on your show. I have to run now. But thanks for having me on the show. It was a great conversation. And I hope that you, all of you, come watch On the Edge with me tonight.
And we don't know what time it's going to be.
It's going to be like 11:30, midnight-ish, something like that.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to check out this Holly Stan... oh my gosh, I'm gonna screw that name up 500 times. And tonight, Holly is just going to rip on me on the chat. If I'm in that chat room, it's like dead meat here. Ding, ding, ding. I got you, bitch. Basically, right?
Uh-huh.
Anyway, like I said, I can make fun of people. They can make fun of me. It's all fun and games.
Mm-hmm.
And good luck trying to get on iHeartRadio. You are... good luck.
Yeah.
I just blew my shot at iHeartRadio because I think I said the F word, the S word, I think I said so many cuss words, it's unreal.
You can cuss. You just can't have it in, like, your name of the show or your actual name. But you can cuss on the show.
Cool.
Yeah, cool.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to get out of here. I'm hungry. I need to take a shower. Holly needs to prepare for her show tonight. If you want to check out the Holly show, go right ahead. It's On the Edge.
I've got one thing to say to everybody. I'm Holly Stalin.
And I don't want you to fall for me. I want you to jump.
That is interesting. Okay. Sorry, I have to do that one more. You have to do that one more time, okay? Sorry, where's the...
Say it again.
Where's the... And you know what? Hit it. Get a clue.
Then I looked at me, and I started to see, and a voice inside tells me what I must do. Wake up, boo-boo, it's me, it's a get-a-clue. It's very exciting, get-a-clue.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, check out the Holly Stalin, whatever. The Holly Show. Holly, are you still there? Check out the On the Edge with the Holly Show. You wouldn't miss it because she's gonna roast me like Norna Mao here. It's gonna be on like Donkey Kong. Mm-hmm. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have to say goodbye to you. Peace out, Holly. Thank you so much for joining me on my show. I hope you can join me tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, my show is gonna be on at 9 o'clock a.m. tomorrow. Okay, so if you want to join me at 9 o'clock a.m., go right ahead. Because doing this show at 11 o'clock is really, really, really screwed up with me. Ladies and gentlemen, say goodbye to Holly one more time. Holly, this is the... If you want to check the show out, go On the Edge with Holly Stalin. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to fall for her... You better have a parachute because you're gonna jump for her.
Oh yeah.
If she says how jump, you say how high.
Exactly.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are gonna be out of here in about 5 seconds. This is the Annie Bond Show. If you wanna join me on any of this web any of my conversations, go to www.TheAnnieBondShow.webs.com or check me on Skype at Andrew.Bond2. Or if you want to email me, if you have a great show idea, find me on Facebook. If you want to email me, it's AndyBondShow@AOL.com. Holly, do you want to say anything on your, do you have any websites that you want to go out before we head out?
Follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook, it's all Holly Stalin, and like my Facebook page, On the Edge.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Annie Bond Show and Holly saying peace. Bye, motherfuckers.
Bye, motherfuckers.